We're back.
Awesome. All right, so we had somebody pull up and the dogs all went crazy and we sort of shifted around a little bit and we're back to work here. Good boy. Ah, I see. That's the first time I brought the TikTok around to that right eye versus the left eye, and that felt a little more reaction, like a more of a fearful reaction than the other side. Good boy. So we'll have to pay attention to that. So ideally, you would get this horse where he knows that when we set this up, it is his opportunity to relax and release whatever garbage is in him. So this could be, he's just standing here kind of processing and relaxing. Some horses would gallop in this. It doesn't matter. He can do whatever he wants to do. And whatever he does will give you some input, will give you some information. Okay, if you square your feet's on. Good job, buddy. More lateral flexion. I think he wants to be good. You want to be okay. Perfect. Awesome. So I would love it if he could relax enough to be able to turn and start investigating the environment. Yay! Pawing is good.
Explain what pawing to the dirt means.
Well, that's a great question. When horses paw, the front feet go along with the left side of the brain, so that's details, piece by piece. But another thing that the pawing does is in the dirt, in the earth, the inside of the earth is full of electrons that have this zen, beautiful, relaxed charge. Everything on the outside of the earth has some amount of charge, and a lot of the stuff on the outside here has a lot of positive, chaotic charge. If your horse is holding a lot of positive, chaotic charge, it's absorbed a lot of stuff from around, it will often paw to get to those zen electrons, and it may, there he goes. He'll release, and it would be wonderful if he would lay down. Well, this is nice. He's not even really paying attention to you. He looks a little relaxed, you think?
He looks really relaxed, yeah.
But I love it when we have distractions. Because real life is about distractions. And if that distraction would count as a stressor, does the horse leave and lose his mind when the distraction goes by? And no, he noticed, and then he's like, you know, I really like feeling calm. Look at these feet look awesome. So when he paws the ground, we were talking about pawing. When he paws the ground, it's like he's digging deeper into the earth to get more access to these zen charge electrons. So he can release, sort of like a lightning bolt hits the ground to neutralize that positive chaotic charge. Your horse is gonna dig and put its face down, and it can also neutralize its positive chaotic charge. The best way to neutralize it would be to actually lay down and have his skin flat on that ground, absorbing the electrons, releasing it. And it's kind of like that. I say it's new, but obviously it's not new. The new idea of earthing or grounding. And another piece of the pawing, and I'm so glad Sharon asked about that, is that if a horse were to lie down in your presence on the rope, the horse is giving you such a huge compliment. A horse is not going to lie down if they think you're about to shapeshift into a predator. The horse is not going to lie down if it feels unsafe in the environment. So by pawing, that's kind of the beginning of this lying down pattern, he's starting to feel really safe standing out here with me. And that's what we want. I want a horse that will say, I'll let you drive. You can drive my car, I feel safe, or you can drive, and then he can go over here in the passenger seat, and he can either fall asleep, he can watch the world go by, He can sing at the top of his lungs, whatever he needs to do to feel okay. But he's starting to let me drive. This is awesome. So there he's licking his lips. He still keeps wanting to come up. Now, part of the reason that he wants to come up to me is he's like, I am so stoned on these endorphins, I feel great. And he's wanting to associate that with me. And the horses, if you'll do this kind of stuff, they get where they associate you with this overall sense of well-being, with this zen, with this wonderful feelings. Kind of, well, this isn't a great example, but sort of like a drug dealer for a crackhead. The crackhead has got to find the drug dealer. They are so connected to that drug dealer. And we are now sort of becoming his drug dealer for relaxation and trust and connect and love. And he's like, I am digging this. So if you come out, how could you do this? You could try to set this up. But another way that you could do some playground of safety is just hold your horse over the grass and let it graze. Grazing is a great way for a horse to release and neutralize things. But this standing where there's not grass, this gives you lots and lots of information. And I think he may not lie down today, but I think if we can't, if I were to come back tomorrow or the, you know, a day or so from now, I think this one's gonna lay down. Oh, okay, did you see this sort of jerky? Could you see the like jerky muscles, Sharon?
Yeah.
Well, there was a moment where he's sort of like, and I love that he did that.
He also crossed his front legs significantly.
Oh, good, 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 good. The crossing the front legs is a huge big deal we'll talk about in a minute. But the jerking, this twisting and jerking of the body is a huge deal. Sympathetic nervous system, survival, fight, flight, freeze, has its own set of muscles. They are called the mobilizer muscles. Those are your gross motor skill, mechanical dump truck muscles. Those are the muscles that the horses that are going around that look like zombies, those horses are often using those muscles. They're not present, they don't jump that great, they don't move that great, but they just look like, they're not home. Parasympathetic nervous system also has its own muscles. Those muscles are called the stabilizer muscles, and those are your fine-tuned dancer muscles. And anybody that rides hunters, especially, knows that we would rather be riding the dancer than the dump truck. The dump truck is our mechanical fear-induced horse. So when a horse has been stuck using these mobilizer muscles all the time, they have only gained their balance using those muscles. And when you fix it up where they start to switch over into parasympathetic nervous system, like this one is doing, we're gonna just try to fix this up. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Good boy. Let's back him up and get this fixed up. Good job. So we can see when he got a little stressed there, he didn't freak all the way out, but he didn't just relax either. So we've still got a little ways to go.
He also, when he was walking around you, you got him to disengage that hind end, and that helped get him to relax and quiet so you could take the rope from around his legs.
And you're so right. It helps having somebody sitting on the side watching as well as sitting here. It did, and he settled right back down, so that was good. You know, stuff is going to happen. Bags are going to fly by. Things are going to happen, and we need to have a horse that can self-soothe, that can solve these puzzles by relaxing or connecting. But anyway, if your horse has got all his muscles in this tight sympathetic nervous system, group of muscles, the mobilizers, and you start to switch that horse over by the relaxation we're doing, often they don't have the stabilizer muscles organized up for balance. And when those horses start to switch over, they can do these weird jerks. And that's one of the things that I saw there. The shaking is a really good thing. That's all these things are starting to relax, and it feels itchy, like your leg or your arm is going to sit.
Also, the space between his hind legs has widened.
Oh, it has, yes, thank you. So this is feeling pretty nice and peaceful, good job. So I may look for, there's some licking of the lips. We'll see, we'll give him another second here. Because we may have gotten, sort of, he's gotten a lot better, but we may do a little tapping here in a second, because I think this one really needs that. I love all the shaking. Yeah, I see your muscles starting to shake. Now we can really see those vertical lines on his side. Can you see those, Sharon?
Yes.
All right, maybe.
Maybe turn him a little bit.
I'll turn him a little bit, and then we're going to start setting up our tapping. Can you move your feet here, Peter? Is that better?
Mm-hmm.
Good boy.
He almost could lift his back a little more.
We'll get it.
Yeah.
We'll get it. It has actually come up some since we started.